Hey guys, the Turtle Dork back again with another review for you this week. I have for you John Wick Chapter 2. Now, if it looks a little bit different, I'm playing around with different areas of my apartment and doing these reviews to see if I can make it a little bit more dynamic. So, kind of bear with me. But getting back to the review, John Wick Chapter 2. Great film that I thoroughly enjoyed. I love the way this film starts off with that projection of the Buster Keaton film on the building, and then as you pan down, we're right into the action with this car chase scene through New York City. That kind of is leading into John Wick searching for his car from the first film, and then we have Peter Stormare, who plays the brother of the villain from the last film, and he really is there for a lot of exposition to kind of get people caught up, or for people who haven't seen the first John Wick movie to kind of get an understanding of who this man is. And it's done with a lot of tongue-in-cheek. And Peter Stormare, if you've seen him in any other films, he does a great job of kind of playing these very tongue-in-cheek, chewing up the scenery type of villains. And just his dialogue when he's talking about the legend that is John Wick, and killing like three men in a bar with a pencil, it's great stuff. And this is like the cold opening, everything that we get right before we get the title card. So this is really kind of preparing the audience for the type of film that they're about to embark on. And I absolutely love this beginning. It definitely sets the tone and the mood for what we're about to see. Now, I don't want to give too much of the story away. The story is very kind of straightforward and very simplistic. The one thing that I really do like about these John Wick films is that these are really a showcase for the stuntman. And they do some absolutely incredible stunt work. But again, with that, I don't want to give too much of the story. I kind of want this to kind of unfold for the audience as you kind of see it. But what I will say is that the first act of this movie kind of moves a little bit slow. That'll probably be my first slight criticism. It does take a time for everything to kind of get going, but once we get towards the end of that first act, everything, and he gets to Rome to kind of go on his mission, everything really, really starts to kind of ramp up. The one thing that I really enjoy about this world of John Wick is that it really feels like a secret society of like hitmen. And you see that all across the globe. And I like the whole thing with the Continental, and they really do a great job of expanding that mythology of the Continental when he goes to Rome. And then it really does feel like a superhero type of film where he has his suit. It's like a bulletproof suit where it's layered with like Teflon so that, you know, the bullets won't penetrate him when he gets shot. It'll hurt like hell, but it will protect him. So like that nice little three-piece suit, you can kind of say it's like his superhero outfit, so to speak. And then when he goes to see the guy about what type of weapons he would need, and just the dialogue, that's the back and forth, and how they kind of play those scenes out, I think is really nifty and really clever. Now, like I said, as we get towards the end of that first act, when we get to the first kind of really big set piece, it kind of takes place in Rome, underground in the catacombs, and this was so much fun to watch. It feels like a video game in a lot of respects. He has these weapons that he places in different areas of the catacombs, and so when he's being attacked by a lot of these different people who are coming after him in the catacombs, he'll start with his 9mm, then he'll go to another area where he has like his shotgun, he'll pick that up, then he has to reload, and it feels so much like a first person shooter video game. It's so much fun to watch. I really enjoyed this rivalry that John Wick has with the character of Cassian, played by Common, and Common is so good. He has this very focused professionalism and this drive towards John that is unrelenting, and he plays it stone cold, stone faced, and they have some great battles. In Rome, they have a great, like, nice little fight scene. And even within the action, they're able to incorporate some bits of comedy. And again, I don't want to give too much away, but it works really well. Again, the stunt work that's on display, the fight scenes that he has with Common's character, when you see them rolling down the steps, when you see like the close quarters combat fighting style that they have in Rome, and when they get back to New York on the subway train. And we also have no shortage of headshots. If you remember the first film, this film has just as many, if not more, headshots. and some other brutal things that happen to a lot of different people with a lot of different type of instruments and weapons. The end of this film too is a nice little homage to Enter the Dragon, where we kind of get this this beautiful looking set piece that kind of takes place in like these corridors of mirrors. And when this action scene was starting to begin, and you really see this set design, it's so reminiscent of Enter the Dragon, and you can really tell that the filmmakers have a love affair with that film. And I thought it was really nice to kind of have that nice little homage to that Bruce Lee classic, and also building on that mythology and that. The legend of John Wick and this whole world building, just everything with the Continental. And then Ian McShane, I thought, was absolutely fantastic as the manager of the New York hotel or the New York chain of the Continental. And I like that even within this world, there is a code that all of these assassins and hitmen have to follow, is that you do not take care of business on the grounds of the Continental. And you really see that in this film, where there's some fight scenes that happen, and the fight scenes end up on the grounds of the Continental. So then they have to quietly stop and go to the bar and have a drink like gentlemen and like professionals. It's really cool to see a film that really follows the rules that they've set up from the beginning, and they don't stray away from that to make it seem kind of unbelievable. Another small criticism that I have is that I do think towards the end of the film, they kind of do some things that's a little bit cartoonish and a little bit over-exaggerated, where, again, how I was saying, this feels like a secret society of this world of hitmen, is that to see how big this world is, they really, really test your suspension of disbelief towards like around the last scene of the film. But it doesn't take away the joy and the fun that this film has. Also, Lawrence Fishburne, we have to talk about him. He is definitely having a lot of fun on camera. You talk about chewing up scenery, he is definitely chewing up scenery in this movie. It feels like he's trying to do his best Sam Jackson, but again, nobody can yell or be over exaggerated as good as Sam Jackson. But Lawrence Fishburne, he does a great job, and I give him kudos for trying. I mean, that line is just, I think that's gonna be a line that we're gonna hear for years to come, is somebody get this man a gun. Man, it was so much fun, and you could tell he was having a lot of fun in that role. And it was kind of cool to see him and Keanu Reeves on screen together again. You know, a nice little Matrix reunion. We just gotta get Carrie Ann Moss back in there, and we'll have the Trinity. Haha, the Trinity there again. But I absolutely had so much fun with this film. John Wick Chapter 2, definitely go check this out. Minor gripes here and there, so with the score, I'm gonna go ahead and give it a solid B. So I'm gonna go ahead and give it an 85 out of 100, but definitely worth checking out. Go ahead and check out John Wick Chapter 2. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Go ahead, rate, like, subscribe, share, and go ahead and check out my other dorks, at Mouth Dork, at The Disco, at The Disco Dork, and at Sidewalk Siren. And for me, I am The Turtle Dork. And with that, I'm out.